Welcome back, everybody. Gotham Crime Bosses. This looks like an awesome battle. I want to give it its own part. The good old days is what it's called at the start of the game. Add two Ghosts of Gotham Past to your decks. Got Catwoman right there. Hopefully we'll see the card. I should have part of the video one scene before that so you could see what that card did. But oh well. I forgot to do that. Two gold cards. These are potentially game winning though. There's only one of each of them in the deck. We do have that Superman card. Wait, actually, I just don't mulligan the first round. I just don't. So let's just keep them. But yeah, you should probably technically mulligan at least one of those, but I don't know if I actually would in that case. Because they're that insane no good. Especially considering the deck we're in. Okay, Clayface just showed up. That is not exactly what you want to see. We do not have a great counter either. Ugh. We have a counter with Misfit. Although questionable counter, she could easily dodge any spell. We got Alfred. Let's just see. Two-Face. Can we trust our VD? Choose an enemy recruit. Flip a coin to decide. KO them or draw a card. That's his exact power. That is incredibly great. Scarecrow has plus... This is Scarecrow. Has plus 3 attack for each fear toxin in your opponent's hand. Create a fear toxin in your opponent's hand. Woo! That sounds like a permanent buff, too. That is pretty brutal. I think we just gotta hope. Well, let's see what Batman does. Maybe it's a different Batman. Plus 3 this turn, seek any gadget. No, that's regular power. Robin is plus 3 attack and Hunter this turn. Robin actually isn't in the game as a leader. This is really cool to see. And Hunter this turn, a random friendly Batman leader gains plus 1 charge. Dude, Robin freaking rocks. He is lesser without Batman though, so I think we guard Batman. Oh, I don't know if lesser is less effective, really. We just hope they can't do 1 damage to Misfit. It's so easy to. And then we also gotta hope he can't buff Clayface beyond what poor Misfit can kill. But it's... Oh, but we're gonna have, like, attack coming next turn for Batman. Yeah, that's gonna be hard for them to do that, but you never know. With Clayface dex is possible. They can get out of control, like, real quick. Especially when they get Mad Hatter. Oh, no. Here comes the buff. Oh, good. That was not... At least that wasn't Arkham Inmate. And here, my goodness, it is, wow. Just dropped freaking 10, 11 attack technically by turn 2. And he's hidden. We can't even attack him. Luckily he attacks randomly because it's chaotic, but unfortunately it's never his own guys. We're definitely going to want heals from freaking... Oh my goodness, we have a suboptimal turn too. Oh, rough. We still want to put him in the back though. This is questionable. Although, we do have him too, but... That's right, this isn't permanent. This is just next turn now. That's right, the nerfs to Batman. Honestly, I think we just grab the Batarang. And then she can just clear him. Yeah, then he clears that. Yeah, that's going to be way helpful. Also, this is permanent damage, not just a random debuff. She's gonna die anyway in this exchange. This is that's pretty ideal, actually. Although we could have... Oh, we could have taken him out. I don't think it matters. Like, it kind of had to play out that way anyway. It's just who was taking what out at that point. But this saved Batman from taking 5 damage from frickin'... So yeah, I think that's still the play you just do to save Batman without hope there. And yeah, we still don't have another bronze, but that's okay. Our mid to late game is just gonna be stellar, but they got an incredible early game. But that can happen, and then they can fizzle out. So we'll see. But we don't want a mid deal getting any stronger, because Batman has freaking 6 attack here. Batman takes no return damage. So, oh no. Of course, didn't let Alfred live. But hey, he just saved 4 damage. Yeah, that was technically super inefficient because Alfred has only like 2 life, I think. Oh yes, this is good. We got Commissioner Gordon. We can place sustained effort into Commissioner Gordon. That's actually quite freaking good. But it's also this, but he don't have that many gadgets for Batwing. Unfortunately, we don't have it. Oh my goodness. It's still rough. We can only use 1 mana. It's really freaking rough. But this is a good play. Freaking hidden. Unbelievable. It's pretty nightmare fuel. Oh, Two-Face. Wait, what? Wait, what? Did they cast Two-Face's ability against nothing and the game let them do that? Did that let him guarantee draw a card? I think it might have. That's interesting. I don't think I had anyone to play. I don't think he destroyed anyone with that move. Oh, there's Fear Toxin. And he was sending the clowns. Luckily, we only had one. Oh, he only needed one. And they killed Robin in 1 turn. Oh my goodness, here it is, the super early game cheese. This is not looking good. Can the Batman hold? This is not looking good. This is not looking good at all. This is full nightmare. This could actually happen in a tournament. I mean, they'd actually make better heroes, actually. But I mean, this is pretty insanely good, though. Oh my goodness. We need Lucius Fox to upgrade these cards. If we don't have it, though, I don't even know if he's in the deck, honestly. 1 damage. 1 damage can get value. Can kill the clone. The clonish clown. Whatever the frick it is. A clown ambush. Oh, boy. This is going to be so freaking hard. Then we can do, I could do Straitjacket. What is freaking, I think we just have to take the Batarang to counter the freaking clown. Oh wait, no, we can have Commish Gordon's here. Commish Gordon can clear the other guy. Batman can then, but then we can alternatively take out Deadshot. We can almost clear the whole board actually here. We can make a comeback here actually. I may just want to actually do double freaking minions to try to get board control. What does this say? Generate Bronze. Scarecrow has +3 for each fear in your hand. Wait, the fear toxin? Oh, I see. Use silver to generate a bronze. Oh my goodness, dang. Do I want to clear with the fear toxin? That's a new game mechanic for just this mission. A new card. We have such powerful plays here, though. Batwing is not actually going to be very powerful. Actually, if we're going to play the Batarang, we want to play him now, so he's buffed up by the Batarang play. I feel like we can get good board control if we just play powers, though. And then we can save the straitjacket for a gold. Yeah, I think that's the play. Yeah, I think we play Batarang. And we play Batwing. Oh, he gave us a -2. The question is, do we want to kill Deadshot or not? That's the big question. Nah, I think we gotta leave him. I don't think sustained effort, I don't think it's a great play right now. Oh wait, actually maybe it was to get another car. Oh shoot, it's too late now. It would have been good, because it would have triggered Batwing and Commissioner Gordon. That may have been the best play there, but it doesn't actually give us as net total power next play. As weird as that is, it actually doesn't. But I think that may have been better for Batwing, actually, because it would have got Batwing 1 more attack, which then he would have been like an unstoppable beast-ish. Oh well. But I'd honestly like to save that when I have, like, Alfred's or, Bluebird's on the field. But that may have been a better play with sustained effort, actually. I don't use this card that much. I don't know if I fully saw that. What is this? Contingency plan? Permanently increase the enemy's ability cost by 3? That's extremely great contingency plan. Oh my goodness, Two-Face is going to be able to trigger next turn. Oh no. Maybe we did want to use sustained effort. Yikes. This could go south so bad. Although... Wait now, we were... Wait. Look at this. We remove his... Oh no, that won't. We won't be able to kill him. No, I think we just do what we're gonna do. Yeah, I think we can weaken him, actually. Oh, maybe I should have weakened him. Oh, no, he has Hunter. No, that was a better play. He has Hunter. Now I Batarang this. There, now he'll choose. It's like, he'll still probably kill Huntress, but he really might kill Batwing. Batwing's actually maybe the better play, actually, at that point. That just seems bad. We gotta kill freaking Amigdala. So he runs out of cards, he's gonna, like, freaking... Especially double his attack. I think we just clear Hugo, actually. Yeah, that just clears the attack off. We clear Hugo. Although he was weakened for only the one turn. Oh, dang it, I forgot about that. We should have attacked Deadshot, I guess, at that point. But no, I think that's a better play, because he has buffs. He has buffs to his peeps, so the more of them alive, he could buff up for one turn. Yeah, we wouldn't want that. Yep, he got it. Harvey Dent just... Wow. He got the super lucky hit. He Harvey Dented Batwing. Well, we didn't go all in on Batwing, and that may have been a good play there, but, like, that sucks, because I think we could have... had him at one health had I played that card, but... Oh, my... He just got a Solomon Grundy. That's really annoying. We can gold it up, though, now. I don't know if it matters. We're just going to get freaking killed at this point, I think. It's not looking good at all. Wait, we can straightjacket Solomon Grundy. I think that's the play, actually. Get Batman out, straightjacket Solomon Grundy. Have Huntress kill Deadshot. Unfortunately, then... Yeah, I should have saved that for now. Yeah, I should have saved that, because I didn't realize freaking he could just kill him. That's unfortunate. I didn't know who he would pick, actually. Because I thought I may have picked Huntress as well. They technically were the same, but that was probably the better play. What does this do? Permanently increase their... No, they're still not going to do anything. We can wait till next turn for that. They're still... Their powers aren't going to trigger. The Scarecrow attacks are brutal, though. But I need the ability to silver. The Scarecrow is just wrecking me. I think that's the play. We just gimp Grundy with this move. And we summon Batman and we hope he can't actually kill us. Yeah, and then next turn if they do live, although... Wait, did we leave Deadshot? No, he has Ventriloquism. We can't. As is, that may kill Huntress. Dang. We're so close to actually taking them both out, actually, in one turn. But, like, next turn we can theoretically take out one, I think. We might be one damage off. Dang. I think we do this. But it's possible he's just going to kill up a Scarecrow, honestly. Which, that wouldn't be terrible, because that would have done the damage. And then we could take one out with Batarang. That won't be played. But hopefully gimping Grundy will slow him down, because we may have the freaking advantage here, but Ventriloquist is Nightmare. And what the heck, this is a new card. Oh my gosh, he got two-faced! Whoa, dang, I think we're dead. Of course they all hit Batman to instantly kill him. Of course! Look at that. Ha ha ha! That's supposed to be random. I don't know if it was that time. If that was random, what just happened is maybe one of the rarest things on Earth you'll ever see. I don't think that was random. I think that was a special play of the card. I still knew it was going to happen, though. When you know the opponent's going to cheat, they can cheat. And yes, that is why they re-roll away the lake. But hey, if you guys didn't see the last video, now you can see this cool shot. Yeah, this is the same play as before. I'm not going to reread that. And here we go. Oh, I didn't show you what the card did, unfortunately. Maybe that's the secret blessing. We didn't get the other card that came anyway. The special card. I want to see the special card. My goodness, though. That is like full nightmare what they did to us. I saw it potentially coming. I doubt it's going to happen again. Once again, we have 2 golds. Generally, the rule of thumb is that I do not mulligan unless I lose 3 times. Just to give something to you guys if you get these, quote, terrible hands. Like, it's already a much better hand, though, because we have the freaking guard right off the start. I might be able to get away with Alfred, though, actually. But yeah, that smackdown they gave us, there's no way that the Cowper is going to get us out of that one. If I played the other thing. Here's Robin with 1 less health because they just nerfed him. That's a very strange choice for the game. But I think he was just like the... But him and Cat were like the primo blue. So if you... What the heck? This is a new card. Oh my word, they can increase their health. Well, that explains why they have less health than us. Torture Leaner and gives a... Wow, this is an incredible card. Forgetting Penguin. That's pretty bonkers. Floop up. Miss Martian is... Great and not great all at the same time. But she's good for cards like this, that she'll take them back to the hand. Ooh. Oh, dang. He's gonna... Wait, no, he won't die. We'll counter him. That's what I'm talking about. A little cheap hit him. Yeah, I feel like Two-Face is way more dangerous. Also, he gives him draw power. I wonder where he'll... Once again, we can't play that. That's not great. We have ultimate draw power of Matron, though. Although, that's also why we want to kill Two-Face, because he can bypass him entirely. And he just got the Two-Face. What the hell? He did... What the hell? I don't think a player would ever do what it just did there. Two-Face came down, he drew a card, and then he destroyed his own Two-Face by putting Hugo in the same slot for no reason, when he had 3 other open slots. What a weird misplay. I'll take it, though. And this is why exactly he should not have done that, because now I can just simply trade with Guard here. And or have Batman kill him, which is probably what I'm actually going to do. Wait, no? We can heal him with Miss Martian, like I was talking about. No, that's what we're going to do. It's going to count as a heal, actually. We're going to protect... Actually, they took out Robin before. We're protecting Robin. They did not like Robin. And this will probably heal him. He may lose his attack. He did lose his attack, but it's totes worth. Yeah, and I have no other card to summon here. Yeah, we're going to bring him down. Bring him back down, and now we can trigger Batman. Oh my goodness, we can freaking grappling hook him again. We can do it again with a grappling hook. I can also do it to Alfred. We don't have a bronze right now. This man should be a play. The Batarang's so good. Oh no, he has Ventriloquist guy. I think we want the Batarang because the Ventriloquist guy's around. Let's just clear this with Batman. It's a little kooky. And Alfred is just going to cheap shot Two-Face in the face. Which is 100% canonically correct now. Alfred is just beating up Two-Face. Absolutely correct. Something you see all the time. Oh, here's the Fear Toxin. And Riders in the empty spaces. This is also why the Batarang is quite good. Alfred can actually take some of those on. That's pretty great, actually. And double bronze. I think we do actually get rid of Toxin here. Our bronze is essentially just Alfred. Yeah, that's the perfect time to get rid of the Toxin. It hurts, though, because we still essentially lost that mana, because I have no bronze play still, but... I'm not going to play Straight Jacket anyway, so that's a perfect time for us, actually. Now let's get Robin out. Nerf Robin. And here's where I was talking about, where we could bring him up. I can just heal him, though. Healing him is also quite powerful in this situation. But I kind of want to hold on to all of that in case we get Batwing and make him insane or strong in order to play it right before Batmobile. This is rough, though, because this is a great counter if we do keep him alive. Arkham Guard. And I don't like bringing all my... hurting my guys by a little bit because they do have that other play. How many cards do I have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I'm almost at max cards, though. And Matron will probably be the play after, which I believe will be next turn. We can play Matron. Just give us draw power dominance. I think we heal him. I'm just going to heal him once. I'm going to heal him once. Because I believe he has, yeah, he has 5 health right now. I'm not going to waste that heal, though. Then we're going to take out the dude in the back with the Batarang. Although, honestly, the AI may destroy its own cards with how crazy it's playing, but, like, I can't rely on that to actually happen. I'm going to do that, do this, and then rather than wasting your 6 attack on just a 1 health creature and or summon, I'm going to do the 6 damage on freaking Two-Face. And then in turn. I'm going to play this freaking serious. So we got freaking Miss Martian. Heck yeah, dude. Very hard card to play. He just got Riddler. Oh, here's Tweedledee, Tweedledum. And there we go. He sacrificed him into the guard. The guard countered as it needed to. Yeah, we didn't need to lose health with Miss Martian there. Some people would have misplayed that. Ooh, we actually got Sonic Cannon. I almost never use... At the start of your opponent's turn, they seek a card and put it in your hand. In my hand? Wait, isn't it their hand? If it's my hand, I want Sonic Cannon. If it's their hand, I want to give him Warlord. Because we need to kill it with a Batman Batarang. At the start of your opponent's turn, they seek a card. Oh, they seek a card and put it in your hand. I think that should say their hand. I think it's Warlord. I do not want to give him Sonic Cannon. I think this is not as it's saying here. We could just give him Sonic Cannon. It's certainly very inefficient for its freaking power. But yeah, you wouldn't have a card like the Riddler that debuffed you. The Riddler must give it to the player. It says my hand, though. I'm going to say that's a misprint. Yeah, see, it went to them. Yep. It went to them. That's what I thought. I remembered Riddler's actual power. At the start of your opponent's turn, they seek a card and put it in your hand. It should say their hand. Oh my goodness, it is in the deck. It's Bat Signal. Oh my goodness, this is a Bat Signal, which is also why Miss Martian's in the deck. Okay, what does Robin do? Robin gets +300 and charges Batman. Yeah, let's do Robin here. Yeah, we have to take out Tweedledum now, yeah, and give your other inmates one attack, one, yeah, they're just gonna buff to the end of time. That cannot be allowed. And let's grab the Batarang, because he may summon Warlord next turn. We got the counter for him. I think Alfred can probably cheap shot Scarecrow, but we'll see here. Do we have a kill here? There's a good chance we do have a kill here. Yeah, Robin can clear this and we can just kill freaking Two-Face before he's about to trigger two. Yeah, we gotta do that. Oh, but then we can't clear out Tweedledum. Well, we can if we use our Batarang. Or sacrifice for Alfred. Well, this is the thought. This is why they give you infinite time for these ones. Also, it's a way to learn the game. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. I have 9 cards in my hand. Yikes. We can heal him up, actually. So he'll survive the exchange if I double heal him. That's a little goofy. I can alternatively use Robin to take him out. Batman and them can kill. He could, yes, that's the play. Oh, no, he has 5 health, this ain't gonna work. I think this Robin has to kill. This Robin kills. No, I don't think this is possible to clear board and kill Harvey Dent. I don't think it's possible. Wait, we do have a straitjacket, though. Wait, does that change anything? Does that change anything? He threes. Wait, he fives. That force, I think if we heal... I'm trying to hold on to the Batarang. I think if I... remove this guy's attack, we could maybe do it? Because then Alfred won't die? That's so weird, though. But I think it will work. Because he's only got one health to restore. He's gonna die anyway. But it would be trading him to die here, although I could double heal him so it won't happen. Almost. Heck yeah, let's do it freaking... But then I will not use my golds, but whatever. We're gonna try to play this. This is silly. This is so silly what I'm about to do. It's so unnecessary. But we're gonna try to play this full preserving life Batman playstyle. This is so bonkers unnecessary. Cause it makes way more sense to not do that. Yeah, he has 5 attack, right? Yeah. Because Robin gets beat up for no reason doing this. Like, this isn't what you'd actually do in a battle. Oh, wait, that's right. I already seeked a gadget this turn. That's right, he's activated. Yeah, you can't do that twice. Yeah, this is also why I'm in that dilemma. You can't actually do that twice, which I think is a little goofy. But I also don't like that part of the game. If you have the charges, you should be able to constantly be tricking the hero. But yeah, I just think that's OP. Let's see here. Then... then Batman? Yeah, I don't think it matters who takes what out. I want just friggin' Robin to take out Two-Face. And Miss Martian. It's KO. She earns it. And then Batman hits here. Hits here. Then we heal him... twice. Because he's buffed up. And we KO him. The needlessly insanely complex. You probably then should just crush one of these guys for a gold cost. Oh, wait, I didn't play it. Yeah, I didn't play Bat Signal. I could have played Bat Signal, actually, but I actually didn't do that because we need each character to attack. Well, that's why I planned that out, because if one person didn't matter, then we could have bat-signaled them. But we can bat-signal Alfred next turn. And deal 2 damage, and they died anyway! The 3 of them died anyway! Welcome to DC. Well, now we have plenty of room to summon strong stuff. And now we can clear Bane. Yeah, Batman can just go absolutely bonkers, actually. We can grab another Batarang and clear Bane now. Bane only does this offensively. Most people do not know that. Batman can't just straight up attack Bane, and he will not be debuffed by it. He's going to lose a lot of health. But we're going to put Matron right behind him anyway. We should technically maybe summon... wait, how many cards do I have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I have a lot of cards as it. Do we even need Matron's power? I don't use the signal that much. I think we put signal down because he just freaking did that goofiness. I'm gonna do 6 damage to him. Hunter, deploy. Your recruits with Hunter get ambush. Unfortunately, we cannot use bat signal again. We'll just bring Montoya down here. Wait, they made Montoya Hunter herself now? Interesting, it does give her ambush if you speed force her. Interesting. For one turn. Yeah, interesting. If she had speed force, she can attack there. Interesting. She does do it to herself. And you just give us free attacks. So. And poison freaking Ivy, yikes. And there's Warlord that we already have the cannon for. Very nice. Wow, he actually attacked there. And yes, we drew the new card I wanted to see, Ghost of Gotham Past. Evade. When this attacks and damages an enemy leader, steal a card from the past and put it in your hand. Unfortunately, we can't actually see what this is going to happen because he only has one health left. But we can still let Robin get ultimate revenge. Buff him up. Buff Robin up. Oh, wait. Oh, this is actually a character. Oh, we'll put her down here then. Oh, she's like a mini Catwoman. Oh, I see. Okay, that's how her power works. And let's just draw cards. See what else in the deck. Yellow draw cards. Oh, here was contingency plan. And now, Robin, get your revenge. Take him out. Oh my goodness, that took a long time, but we did it. Although I was like doing ultimate freaking plan of least loss of life, and then he still just played a spell that killed like them all, but hey, I didn't waste and put a gold down there like other people would have and had a gold take pointless damage there. Perhaps it was dwelling on the past that made him fall. Oh, my Fratman just freaking fell off the rooftop. Look at her shocked. Kitty cat one. Oh my goodness. Oh, he fell in the garbage. He's okay. He fell in the garbage. Awaiting him was the second visitor. Looks like you could use a hand. Superman offered to take Batman on a journey around the city. They stopped first at Bob's home. Merry Christmas, Dad. It's got like a Batman thing. Superman could not believe Batman would use a family as bait. What are you going to do about the boy? Scare him so badly he doesn't dare follow his father's footsteps. What? That sounds like full-on logic. Scare him so badly he doesn't dare follow in his father's footsteps. Superman just dot dot dots. Yeah, seriously. Bruh. Superman wanted to show Batman that there was more to Gotham than crime and pain. Oh, what is this broken sentence? Who do Superman and Batman visit? Who does Superman and Batman visit? I'm gonna say this is a very old story. It may be before, I think it's before English actually was like concreted in with rules. I'm gonna give them the benefit of the doubt, and that's actually written in the original of the film, but I don't know if that's true, because I think it's like from 1880 or something, the original does. It's quite old, at least its setting. That's too funny. A mother reading her daughter a bedtime story. The first two recruits you draw get a shield. Oh, this is where I'm gonna part the video. The first time you have a pair of recruits, they get 2-2. A couple talking in the park. Give a child gifting her grandparents a gift. At the start of the game, your leaders get +5. Wow. Okay, I'll look at this more in the next video. But yeah, that just sounds initially quite powerful. But we'll see. I'll look at it more. Thanks so much for watching. I hope you like what you saw. Please hit that like button. Subscribe. Hit that notification bell. If you'd like to see more content like this. And nothing like it at all. And you are a complete legend for watching the video this long. Anyway. Catch you next time. Pause video to do that stuff now. Anyway, later. Stay awesome, Gotham.